This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Harvard University is a private, Ivy League research university in Cambridge, Massachusetts, established in 1636, whose history, influence, and wealth have made it one of the world's most prestigious universities, established originally by the Massachusetts legislature and soon thereafter named for John Harvard, its first benefactor. Harvard is the United States' oldest institution of higher learning, and the Harvard Corporation, formally, the President and Fellows of Harvard College, is its first chartered corporation, although never formally affiliated with any denomination. The early college primarily trained Congregationalist and Unitarian clergy. Its curriculum and student body were gradually secularized during the 18th century, and by the 19th century Harvard had emerged as the central cultural establishment among Boston elites following the American Civil War. President Charles W. Eliot's long tenure 1869-1909 transformed the college and affiliated professional schools into a modern research university. Harvard was a founding member of the Association of American Universities in 1900. James Bryant Conant led the university through the Great Depression and World War II and began to reform the curriculum and liberalize admissions after the war. The undergraduate college became coeducational after its 1977 merger with Radcliffe College. The university is organized into 11 separate academic units, 10 faculties, and the Radcliffe Institute for Advanced Study, with campuses throughout the Boston metropolitan area. Its 209-acre 85-13 20th century 14 21st century 2 campuses, 21 Cambridge, 22 Alston, 23 Longwood, 24 other, 3 organization and administration, 31 governance, 32 endowment, 321 divestment, 4 academics, 41 admission, 42 teaching and learning, 43 research, 44 libraries and museums, 45 university rankings, 5 student life, 51 student body, 52 athletics, 53 song, 6 notable people, 61 alumni, 62 faculty, 7 literature and popular culture, 71 literature, 72 film, 8 see also, 9 references, 91 citations, 92 further reading, 10 external links. History main article, History of Harvard University Colonial, the official seal of the Harvard Corporation found on Harvard diplomas. It carries the university's original motto, Christo et Ecclesia, Christ and Church, later changed to Veritas, Truth, engraving of Harvard College by Paul Revere, 1767. Harvard was formed in 1636 by vote of the Great and General Court of the Massachusetts Bay Colony. It was initially called New College or the College at New Town. In 1638, the college became home to British North America's first known printing press. In 1639, the college was renamed Harvard College after deceased clergyman John Harvard, who was an alumnus of the University of Cambridge. He had left the school £779 and his library of some 400 books. The charter creating the Harvard Corporation was granted in 1650. In the early years, the college trained many Puritan ministers. A 1643 publication said the school's purpose was to advance learning and perpetuate it to posterity, dreading to leave an illiterate ministry to the churches when our present ministers shall lie in the dust. It offered a classic curriculum on the English university model. Many leaders in the colony had attended the University of Cambridge, but conformed to the tenets of Puritanism. It was never affiliated with any particular denomination, but many of its earliest graduates went on to become clergymen in Congregational and Unitarian churches. The leading Boston divine Increase Mather served as president from 1685 to 1701. In 1708, John Leverett became the first president who was not also a clergyman, which marked a turning of the college toward intellectual independence from Puritanism. 19th century John Harvard statue, Harvard Yard. Throughout the 18th century, Enlightenment ideas of the power of reason and free will became widespread among Congregationalist ministers, putting those ministers and their congregations in tension with more traditionalist, Calvinist parties. 1-4 When the Hollis Professor of Divinity David Tappan died in 1803 and the president of Harvard Joseph Willard died a year later, in 1804, a struggle broke out over their replacement replacements Henry Ware was elected to the chair in 1805, and the liberal Samuel Weber was appointed to the presidency of Harvard 2 years later, which signaled the changing of the tide from the dominance of traditional ideas at Harvard to the dominance of liberal, Arminian ideas defined by traditionalists as Unitarian ideas. 4-5-24 In 1846, the natural history lectures of Louis Agassiz were acclaimed both in New York and on the campus at Harvard College. Agassiz's approach was distinctly idealist and posited Americans' participation in the divine nature and the possibility of understanding intellectual existences. Agassiz's perspective on science combined observation with intuition and the assumption that a person can grasp the divine plan in all phenomena. When it came to explaining life forms, Agassiz resorted to matters of shape based on a presumed archetype for his evidence. This dual view of knowledge was in concert with the teachings of common sense realism derived from Scottish philosophers Thomas Reid and Dugald Stewart, whose works were part of the Harvard curriculum at the time. The popularity of Agassiz's efforts to soar with Plato probably also derived from other writings to which Harvard students were exposed, including Platonic treatises by Ralph Cudworth, John Norris, and, in a romantic vein, Samuel Taylor Coleridge. The library records at Harvard reveal that the writings of Plato and his early modern and romantic followers were almost as regularly read during the 19th century as those of the official philosophy of the more empirical and more deistic Scottish school. Charles W. Eliot, President 1869-1909, eliminated the favored position of Christianity from the curriculum while opening it to student self-direction. While Eliot was the most crucial figure in the secularization of American higher education, he was motivated not by a desire to secularize education, but by transcendentalist Unitarian convictions derived from William Ellery Channing and Ralph Waldo Emerson. These convictions were focused on the dignity and worth of human nature, the right and ability of each person to perceive truth, and the indwelling God in each person. 20th century Richard Rummel's 1906 watercolor landscape view, facing Northeast Harvard Yard as seen from Holyoke Center. During the 20th century, Harvard's international reputation grew as a burgeoning endowment and prominent professors expanded the university's scope. Rapid enrollment growth continued as new graduate schools were begun and the undergraduate college expanded. Radcliffe College, established in 1879 as sister school of Harvard College, became one of the most prominent schools for women in the United States. Harvard became a founding member of the Association of American Universities in 1900. In the early 20th century, the student body was predominantly old stock, high-status Protestants, especially Episcopalians, Congregationalists, and Presbyterians, a group later called WASPs, white Anglo-Saxon Protestants. By the 1970s it was much more diversified. James Bryant Conant, President, 1933-1953, reinvigorated creative scholarship to guarantee its preeminence among research institutions. He saw higher education as a vehicle of opportunity for the talented rather than an entitlement for the wealthy, so Conant devised programs to identify, recruit, and support talented youth. In 1943, he asked the faculty make a definitive statement about what general education ought to be, at the secondary as well as the college level. The resulting report, published in 1945, was one of the most influential manifestos in the history of American education in the 20th century. In 1945-1960, admissions policies were opened up to bring in students from a more diverse applicant pool, no longer drawing mostly from rich alumni of select New England prep schools. The undergraduate college was now open to striving middle-class students from public schools. Many more Jews and Catholics were admitted, but few blacks, Hispanics, or Asians. Harvard graduate schools began admitting women in small numbers in the late 19th century, and during World War II, students at Radcliffe College, which since 1879 had been paying Harvard professors to repeat their lectures for women students, began attending Harvard classes alongside men. The first class of women was admitted to Harvard Medical School in 1945. Since the 1970s, Harvard has been responsible for essentially all aspects of admission, instruction, and undergraduate life for women, and Radcliffe was formally merged into Harvard in 1999. 21st century Drew Gilpin Faust, the dean at Radcliffe, became the first female president of Harvard in 2007. Campuses: Cambridge University seal. Harvard's 209-acre 85. Libraries of the university, academic buildings including Sever Hall and University Hall, Memorial Church, and the majority of the freshman dormitories sophomore, junior, and senior undergraduates live in 12 residential houses, 9 of which are south of Harvard Yard along or near the Charles River. The other 3 are located in a residential neighborhood half a mile northwest of the Yard at the Quadrangle, commonly referred to as the Quad, which formerly housed Radcliffe College students until Radcliffe merged its residential system with Harvard. Each residential house contains rooms for undergraduates, housemasters, and resident tutors, as well as a dining hall and library. The facilities were made possible by a gift from Yale University alumnus Edward Harkness. Radcliffe Yard, formerly the center of the campus of Radcliffe College and now home of the Radcliffe Institute for Advanced Study at Harvard, is adjacent to the Graduate School of Education and the Cambridge Common Memorial Hall. Memorial Church. Between 2011 and 2013, Harvard University reported crime statistics for its main Cambridge campus that included 104 forcible sex offenses, 55 robberies, 83 aggravated assaults, 89 burglaries, and 43 cases of motor vehicle theft. Harvard also has commercial real estate holdings in Cambridge and Alston, on which it pays property taxes. This includes the Alston DoubleTree Hotel, the Inn at Harvard, and the Harvard Square Hotel. Alston. Main article: Harvard University's expansion in Alston, Massachusetts. The Harvard Business School and many of the university's athletics facilities, including Harvard Stadium, are located on a 358-acre 145. Harvard School of Public Health are located on a 21-acre 85. 1816 Law, 1817 Dental Medicine, 1867 Arts and Sciences, 1872 Business, 1908 Extension, 1910 Design, 1914 Education, 1920 Public Health, 1922 Government, 1936 Engineering and Applied Sciences, 2007 Harvard Medical School. Harvard is governed by a combination of its Board of Overseers and the President and Fellows of Harvard College, also known as the Harvard Corporation, which in turn appoints the President of Harvard University. There are 16,000 staff and faculty, including 2,400 professors, lecturers, and instructors teaching 7,200 undergraduates and 14,000 graduate students. The Faculty of Arts and Sciences has primary responsibility for instruction in Harvard College, Graduate School of Arts and Sciences, and the Harvard Division of Continuing Education, which includes Harvard Summer School and Harvard Extension School. There are 10 other graduate and professional school faculties, in addition to the Radcliffe Institute for Advanced Study. Joint programs with the Massachusetts Institute of Technology include the Harvard-MIT Division of Health Sciences and Technology, the Broad Institute, the Observatory of Economic Complexity, and EDX Endowment. Main article: Harvard University Endowment. Harvard has the largest university endowment in the world as of September 2011. It had nearly regained the loss suffered during the 2008 recession. It was worth $32 billion in 2011, up from $28 billion in September 2010 and $26 billion in 2009. It suffered about 30% loss in 2008-09. In December 2008, Harvard announced that its endowment had lost 22%, approximately $8 billion. From July to October 2008, necessitating budget cuts. Later reports suggest the loss was actually more than double that figure, a reduction of nearly 50% of its endowment in the first 4 months alone. Forbes in March 2009 estimated the loss to be in the range of $12 billion. One of the most visible results of Harvard's attempt to rebalance its budget was their halting of construction of the $12 billion Alston Science Complex that had been scheduled to be completed by 2011, resulting in protests from local residents. As of 2012, Harvard University had a total financial aid reserve of $159 million for students, and a Pell Grant reserve of $4,093 million available for disbursement. Divestment. Since the 1970s, several campaigns have sought to divest Harvard's endowment from holdings the campaigns opposed, including investments in apartheid South Africa, the tobacco industry, Sudan during the Darfur genocide, and the fossil fuel industry. During the divestment from South Africa movement in the late 1980s, student activists erected a symbolic shantytown on Harvard Yard and blockaded a speech given by South African Vice Consul Duke Kent Brown. The Harvard Management Company repeatedly refused to divest, stating that operating expenses must not be subject to financially unrealistic strictures or carping by the unsophisticated or by special interest groups. However, the university did eventually reduce its South African holdings by $230 million out of $400 million in response to the pressure academics admission. Undergraduate admission to Harvard is characterized by the Carnegie Foundation as more selective, lower transfer in. Harvard College accepted 53% of applicants for the class of 2019, a record low and the second lowest acceptance rate among all national universities. Harvard College ended its early admissions program in 2007 as the program was believed to disadvantage low-income and underrepresented minority applicants applying to selective universities. Yet for the class of 2016, an early action program was reintroduced. The Undergraduate Admissions Office's preference for children of alumni policies have been the subject of scrutiny and debate as it primarily aids Caucasians and the wealthy and seems to conflict with the concept of meritocratic admissions. Teaching and Learning. Massachusetts Hall 1720, Harvard's oldest building, Harvard Yard. Harvard is a large, highly residential research university. The university has been accredited by the New England Association of Schools and Colleges since 1929. The university offers 46 undergraduate concentrations majors, 134 graduate degrees, and 32 professional degrees for the 2008-2009 academic year. Harvard granted 1,664 baccalaureate degrees, 400 master's degrees, 512 doctoral degrees, and 4,460 professional degrees. The four-year, full-time undergraduate program comprises a minority of enrollments at the university and emphasizes instruction with an arts and sciences focus. Between 1978 and 2008, entering students were required to complete a core curriculum of 7 classes outside of their concentration. Since 2008, undergraduate students have been required to complete courses in 8 general education categories: aesthetic and interpretive understanding, culture and belief, empirical and mathematical reasoning, ethical reasoning, science of living systems, science of the physical universe, societies of the world, and United States in the world. Harvard offers a comprehensive doctoral graduate program, and there is a high level of coexistence between graduate and undergraduate degrees. The Carnegie Foundation for the Advancement of Teaching, the New York Times, and some students have criticized Harvard for its reliance on teaching fellows for some aspects of undergraduate education. They consider this to adversely affect the quality of education. Harvard's academic programs operate on a semester calendar beginning in early September and ending in mid-May. Undergraduates typically take 4 half courses per term and must maintain a 4 course rate average to be considered full-time in many concentrations. Students can elect to pursue a basic program or an honors eligible program requiring a senior thesis and/or advanced coursework. Students graduating in the top 4-5% of the class are awarded degrees summa cum laude, students in the next 15% of the class are awarded magna cum laude, and the next 30% of the class are awarded cum laude. Harvard has chapters of academic honor societies such as Phi Beta Kappa, and various committees and departments also award several hundred named prizes annually. Harvard, along with other universities, has been accused of great inflation, although there is evidence that the quality of the student body and its motivation have also increased. Harvard College reduced the number of students who receive Latin honors from 90% in 2004 to 60% in 2005. Moreover, the honors of John Harvard Scholar and Harvard College Scholar will now be given only to the top 5% and the next 5% of each class. University policy is to expel students engaging in academic dishonesty to discourage a culture of cheating. In 2012, dozens of students were expelled for cheating after an investigation of more than 120 students. In 2013, there was a report that as many as 42% of incoming freshmen had cheated on homework prior to entering the university, and these incidents have prompted the university to consider adopting an honor code for the 2012-13 school year. Annual tuition was $38,000, with a total cost of attendance of $57,000 beginning 2007. Families with incomes below $60,000 pay nothing for their children to attend, including room and board. Families with incomes between $60,000 to $80,000 pay only a few thousand dollars per year, and families earning between $120,000 and $180,000 pay no more than 10% of their annual incomes. In 2009, Harvard offered grants totaling $414 million across all 11 divisions. $340 million came from institutional funds, $35 million from federal support, support, and $39 million from other outside support grants total 88% of Harvard's aid for undergraduate students, with aid also provided by loans 8% and work-study 4% research. This section needs expansion. You can help by adding to it. September 2013 Harvard is a founding member of the Association of American Universities and remains a research university with very high research activity and a comprehensive doctoral program. Across the arts, sciences, engineering, and medicine, research and development expenditures in 2011 totaled $6,497 million, 27th among American universities. Libraries and museums. Widener Library anchors the Harvard University Library System. The Harvard University Library System is centered in Widener Library in Harvard Yard and comprises nearly 80 individual libraries holding over 18 million volumes, according to the American Library Association. This makes it the largest academic library in the United States, and one of the largest in the world. Cabot Science Library, Lamont Library, and Widener Library are three of the most popular libraries for undergraduates to use. With easy access and central locations, there are rare books, manuscripts, and other special collections throughout Harvard's libraries. Houghton Library, the Arthur and Elizabeth Schlesinger Library on the History of Women in America, and the Harvard University Archives consist principally of rare and unique materials. America's oldest collection of maps, gazetteers, and atlases, both old and new, is stored in Pusey Library and open to the public. The largest collection of East Asian language material outside of East Asia is held in the Harvard Yenching Library. Henry Moore's sculpture, large four-piece reclining figure, near Lamont Library. Harvard operates several arts, cultural, and scientific museums. The Harvard Art Museums comprises three museums. The Arthur M. Sackler Museum includes collections of ancient, Asian, Islamic, and later Indian art. The Busch Reisinger Museum, formerly the Germanic Museum, covers Central and Northern European art, and the Fogg Museum of Art covers Western art from the Middle Ages to the present, emphasizing Italian Early Renaissance, British Pre-Raphaelite, and 19th-century French art. The Harvard Museum of Natural History includes the Harvard Mineralogical Museum, Harvard University Herbaria featuring the Blaschka Glass Flowers exhibit, and the Museum of Comparative Zoology. Other museums include the Carpenter Center for the Visual Arts, designed by Le Corbusier, housing the film archive, the Peabody Museum of Archaeology and Ethnology, specializing in the cultural history and civilizations of the Western Hemisphere, and the Semitic Museum, featuring artifacts from excavations in the Middle East. University Rankings. University Rankings National. ARWU 1 Forbes 4 U.S. News 2 Washington Monthly 2 Global ARWU 1 QS 3 times 6 U.S. News 2011, which measured universities' numbers of alumni holding CEO positions in Fortune Global 500 companies. According to the 2016 poll done by the Princeton Review, Harvard is the second most commonly named Dream College in the United States, both for students and parents. College ROI Report, Best Value Colleges by PayScale, puts Harvard 22nd nationwide in the most recent 2016 edition. Student Life Demographics of Student Body. Undergraduate, Graduate, and Professional. U.S. Census. Asian, Pacific Islander 17%, 11%, 5% Black, non-Hispanic 6%, 4%. 12% Hispanics of any race, 9%, 5%, 16% White, non-Hispanic 46%, 43%, 64% Mixed race, other 10%, 8%, 9% International students, 11%, 27% N.A. student body. In the last 6 years, Harvard's student population ranged between 19,000 and 21,000. Across all programs, Harvard enrolled 6,655 students in undergraduate programs, 3,738 students in graduate programs, and 10,722 students in professional programs. The undergraduate population is 51% female, the graduate population is 48% female, and the professional population is 49% female. Athletic main article, Harvard Crimson. Harvard Stadium, home of Harvard Crimson and the Boston Cannons. Harvard men's 8 crew at Henley, 2004. The Cornell Harvard hockey rivalry match, 2006. The Harvard Crimson competes in 42 intercollegiate sports in the NCAA Division I Ivy League. Harvard has an intense athletic rivalry with Yale University, culminating in the game. Although the Harvard-Yale regatta predates the football game, this rivalry, though, is put aside every 2 years when the Harvard and Yale track and field teams teams come together to compete against a combined Oxford University and Cambridge University team, a competition that is the oldest continuous international amateur competition in the world. Harvard's athletic rivalry with Yale is intense in every sport in which they meet, coming to a climax each fall in the annual football meeting, which dates back to 1875 and is usually called simply the game. While Harvard's football team is no longer one of the country's best as it often was a century ago during football's early days, it won the Rose Bowl in 1920. Both it and Yale have influenced the way the game is played. In 1903, Harvard Stadium introduced a new era into football with the first ever permanent reinforced concrete stadium of its kind in the country. The stadium's structure actually played a role in the evolution of the college game, seeking to reduce the alarming number of deaths and serious injuries in the sport. Walter Camp, former captain of the Yale football team, suggested widening the field to open up the game, but the stadium was too narrow to accommodate a wider playing surface, so other steps had to be taken. Camp would instead support revolutionary new rules for the 1906 season. These included legalizing the forward pass, perhaps the most significant rule change in the sport's history. Harvard has several athletic facilities, such as the Leviatus Pavilion, a multipurpose arena and home to the Harvard basketball teams. The Malkin Athletic Center, known as the MAC, serves both as the university's primary recreation facility and as a satellite location for several varsity sports. The five-story building includes two cardio rooms, an Olympic-size swimming pool, a smaller pool for aerobics and other activities, a mezzanine, where all types of classes are held, an indoor cycling studio, three weight rooms, and a three-court gym floor to play basketball. The MAC offers personal trainers and specialty classes. It is home to Harvard volleyball, fencing and wrestling. The offices of several of the school's varsity coaches are also in the MAC. Weld Boathouse and Newell Boathouse house the women's and men's rowing teams, respectively. The men's crew also uses the Red Top Complex in Ledyard, Connecticut, as their training camp for the annual Harvard-Yale Regatta. The Bright Hockey Center hosts the Harvard hockey teams, and the Merce Center serves both as a home for Harvard's squash and tennis teams, as well as a strength and conditioning center for all athletic sports. As of 2013, there were 42 Division I intercollegiate varsity sports teams for women and men at Harvard, more than at any other NCAA Division I college in the country. As with other Ivy League universities, Harvard does not offer athletic scholarships older than the game by 23 years. The Harvard-Yale Regatta was the original source of the athletic rivalry between the two schools. It is held annually in June on the Thames River in eastern Connecticut. The Harvard crew is typically considered to be one of the top teams in the country in rowing today. Harvard fields top teams in several other sports, such as the Harvard Crimson men's ice hockey team with a strong rivalry against Cornell, squash, and even recently won NCAA titles in men's and women's fencing. Harvard also won the Intercollegiate Sailing Association National Championships in 2003. Harvard's men's ice hockey team won the school's first NCAA championship in any team sport. In 1989, Harvard was also the first Ivy League institution to win a NCAA championship title in a women's sport when its women's lacrosse team won the NCAA championship in 1990. Harvard undergraduate television has footage from historical games and athletic events, including the 2005 pep rally before the Harvard-Yale game. The school color is crimson, which is also the name of the Harvard sports teams and the daily newspaper, the Harvard Crimson. The color was unofficially adopted in preference to magenta by an 1875 vote of the student body, although the association with some form of red can be traced back to 1858, when Charles William Eliot, a young graduate student who would later become Harvard's 21st and longest-serving president 1869-1909, bought red bandanas for his crew so they could more easily be distinguished by spectators at a regatta. Song. Harvard has several fight songs, the most played of which, especially at football, are 10,000 Men of Harvard and Harvardiana. While Fair Harvard is actually the alma mater, 10,000 Men is better known outside the university. The Harvard University Band performs these fight songs and other cheers at football and hockey games. These were parodied by Harvard alumnus Tom Lehrer in his song Fight Fiercely, Harvard, which he composed while an undergraduate. Notable people: Alumni main articles, list of Harvard University people and notable non-graduate alumni of Harvard. Second President of the United States John Adams AB, 1755, AM, 1758. Sixth President of the United States John Quincy Adams AB, 1787, AM, 1798. 19th President of the United States Rutherford B. Hayes LLB, 1845. 26th President of the United States and Nobel Peace Prize laureate Theodore Roosevelt AB, 1880. 32nd President of the United States Franklin D. Roosevelt AB, 1903. 35th President of the United States John F. Kennedy SB, 1940. President of Liberia and Nobel Peace Prize laureate Ellen Johnson Sirleaf MPA, 1971. 43rd President of the United States George West Bush MBA, 1975. Founder of Microsoft Bill Gates Call, 1977, LLD, 2007. Secretary General of the United Nations Ban Ki-moon MPA, 1984. 46th First Lady of the United States Michelle Obama JD, 1988. 44th President of the United States and Nobel Peace Prize laureate Barack Obama JD, 1991. Co-founder of Facebook Mark Zuckerberg Call, 2006. Faculty Harvard's faculty includes scholars such as biologist E.O. Wilson, cognitive scientist Stephen Pinker, physicists Lisa Randall and Roy Glauber, chemists Elias Corey, Dudley R. Hirschbach and George M. Whitesides, computer scientists Michael O. Rabin and Leslie Valiant, Shakespeare scholar Stephen Greenblatt, writer Louis Menand, critic Helen Vendeler, historians Henry Louis Gates Jr. and Niall Ferguson, economists Amartya Sen, N. Gregory Mankiw, Robert Barrow, Stephen A. Marglin, Don M. Wilson III and Martin Feldstein, political philosophers Harvey Mansfield, Baroness Shirley Williams and Michael Sandel, Fields Medalist mathematician Xing-Tung Yao, political scientists Robert Putnam, Joseph Nye, and Stanley Hoffman, scholar, composers Robert Levin and Bernard Rands, astrophysicist Alyssa A. Goodman, and legal scholars Alan Dershowitz and Lawrence Lessig. Past faculty members include Michael Walzer, Stefan Thernstrom, Robert Nozick, and Cornell West. Literature and popular culture. The perception of Harvard as a center of either elite achievement or elitist privilege has made it a frequent literary and cinematic backdrop. In the grammar of film, Harvard has come to mean both tradition and a certain amount of stuffiness. Film critic Paul Sherman has said literature William Faulkner's The Sound and the Fury 1929 and Absalom 1936 depict Harvard. Student Life of Time and the River 1935, Thomas Wolfe's fictionalized autobiography, includes his alter ego's student days at Harvard. The late George Apley 1937, winner of the Pulitzer Prize, by John P. Marquand, parodies Harvard Men at the opening of the 20th century. The Second Happiest Day 1953, by John P. Marquand Jr., depicts the Harvard of the World War II generation. Film since 1970. Harvard's policy has been to permit filming on its property only rarely, so most scenes set at Harvard, especially indoor shots, but accepting aerial footage and shots of public areas such as Harvard Square are in fact shot elsewhere. Eric Segal's Love Story 1970, which concerns a romance between a wealthy hockey player Ryan O'Neill and a brilliant Radcliffe student of modest means Ally McGraw, is screened annually for incoming freshmen. The Paper Chase 1973, Prozac Nation 2001, Legally Blonde 2001, Stealing Harvard 2002. The Social Network 2010. See also Boston Portal, Massachusetts Portal, University Portal 2012, Harvard Cheating Scandal, Academic Regalia of Harvard University, Gore Hall, Harvard College, Harvard University Police Department, Harvard University Press, Harvard, MIT Cooperative Society, Campus Bookstore. I2M Harvard List of Universities by Number of Billionaire Alumni, Outline of Harvard University Secret Court of 1920. References, citations. Carat Harvard's Veritas appears on the university's arms. Heraldically speaking, however, a motto is a word or phrase displayed on a scroll in conjunction with a shield of arms. Since 1692, university seals have borne Christo et Ecclesia for Christ and the Church in this manner, arguably making that phrase the university's motto in a heraldic sense. This legend is otherwise not in general use today. Carat, an appropriation of £400 toward a school or college, was voted on October 28, 1636. OS. U.S., at a meeting which convened on September 8 and was adjourned to October 28. Some sources consider October 28, 1636 O.S. November 7, 1636 N.S. to be the date of founding Harvard's 1936 tercentenary celebration, treated September 18 as the founding date, though 1836 bicentennial was celebrated on September 8, 1836. Sources, meeting dates, Quincy, Josiah 1860 History of Harvard University 117 Washington Street, Boston, Crosby, Nichols, Lee & Co. On October 28, 1636 £400 for that school or college, the Great and General Court of the Massachusetts Bay Colony bicentennial date, Marvin Hightower September 2, 2003 Harvard Gazette, This Month in Harvard History Harvard University retrieved September 15, 2006. Carat ABC as of 1 September 2014 Harvard at a Glance Harvard University retrieved November 27, 2014. Carat ARWU, Harvard University Shanghai Ranking Consultancy 2015 retrieved September 3, 2015. Of the Provost, Harvard University 2012 retrieved June 15, 2013. Carat The Complete List of Fields Medal Winners AREPM AG 2014 retrieved September 10, 2015. 29, 2010.